Run up with that list first. Let them know that you're in the building.
Like, my name is Oladimeji Moro. And I want to give a shout out to my uncle.
he's an actor. All of that.
Like, I gotta give a shout out to myself. I'm half Muslim, half Christian.
You're not casting.
Half Christian, half Muslim.
Half casting.
How does that work for you? You go. Do you pick the days that you?
It actually eases me. Like
it
on
eases you.
Yeah, okay. On Friday I'll be like, I'm a Christian. I don't have to go to Jumat. Then on Sunday, I'm a Muslim. I don't have to go to Mosque.
This guy needs God now.
He needs a divine intervention.
Yeah, that's it.
Where some, celestial body arrests him.
We all do need that.
How many girls have you been through this year? Just asking.
How many?
Yes.
Like,
I need to know how many people are praying for you.
Like, how many people are praying for me? My mom is praying for me. I know that definitely.
Yeah, she's banning and casting all the negative prayers coming your way.
I say so.
Tribes, ladies and gentlemen, played Dag Green in that movie, ladies and gentlemen, that Piggy Dag Green's lifetime until his.
Ghetto Dreams.
Ghetto Dreams until his.
But Arthur, if a match is coming, all right, I want to ask him, do you know what it really feels like, getting into the green shoes? Can you really,
what does it feel like getting into the green shoes?
First of all, I gotta say it was a pleasure playing that role because it wasn't really easy for me, trying to picture the kind of life that Green lived before he died and the struggles he went through and all that. But I would say it wasn't really so difficult for me because it was more or less the kind of lifestyle I was into, I was into the everyday, day-to-day hustling. And
you do all the old SK.
I didn't say that.
You go to Oniro, you mean?
So which is
like, when you're like, Oniro, like,
Oniro, like,
Oniro Beach to meet that guy, Sikiru, that cuts punk.
For picnics.
For picnics.
Okay.
Yes, I do go to Oniro for picnics.
You go for picnics.
That's your word.
That's how I remove my last name. Me and Mr. Arthur. So it wasn't really difficult for me fitting into that character, but I really give my fans and God most especially the thanks that he's due, because after the auditions and I was given the scripts and I got to know it was an Ademinok on directing the movie, and a whole lot of A-list superstars, Doris Simon, J1, Richard Omega, Pakasumo, KSB, and a whole lot of other beautiful people, and I had to really, really work on myself, my delivery, my physique, and all that. So it wasn't really difficult for me.
All right, so after doing the whole, playing the role of the green thing as a music, someone just entering the music industry, you doing music now, because I understand you do music now, on the side, you're a musician on the side.
I'll say on the side, I'm a musician. And I'm a musician, then on the side I'm an actor.
Fully you're a musician, on the side you're an actor. Now, I haven't done that role with Dag Green yet. How's the music industry been treating you? Going through as in doing those things that Dag Green did in the movie, how's the music industry been treating you, man?
First of all, I'll say the music industry has been giving me the treatment. They gave the mic when they actually tried to do a single. the industry has been so beautiful, trying to break out into the music industry hasn't been so easy, but we thank God it's not been so easy because people see me more like an actor.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing? People see more like
I
think it's a good thing. I mean, ladies like to move.
No, I don't think it's a good thing. If you think yourself more of an artist than an actor.
Excuse me, I think I would rather hang out with an actor more than a musician.
Why?
I'm just saying.
Why?
I like the ladies.
Okay, because your name is Arthur, right? I love that.
Yeah, so I think that's a good thing. I mean, if people see you more as an actor, I think it's a 50-50 thing.
Yeah, it's a 50-50 thing. Because you're trying to break out as a musician, and a chance came in to play a very major character in a very big, So it came in and I took it, and we are here.
Okay.
So we just try to blend in and all that.
But if I might ask you, alright, do you have any music of your own?
We're gonna do some of his music right now.
First of all, I like to say this once and for all. I've been a musician before the movie Raw came in.
Okay.
Like, I've been signed. I was actually signed to Singomina Records.
Okay.
Which was one of the biggest record companies in the country.
You got to have to do that great song. One of that great songs. Let's see how good you are.
Yeah, that was last year, man.
No, you got to do one of the great songs. We got to see how good it is.
Okay, really?
I think we have ample time to do all of that before the show comes. So, we got one of your tracks coming through right now, ladies and gentlemen. We've got one of Tribes' tracks. We also have my main man, Bass 10, in the building. Yeah, but this title of this one, want to do the introduction? Just do the introduction.
Okay, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Shole Jewani, any team of fair, talk on me, my belloni, Tobati Dale, Jekarira. Okay, this track started, Could It Be You?
Yeah.
Courtesy Kingsbridge Entertainment. You know, that's what's up.
That's what's up about this market, man.
You don't want it.
Cross-carpeting. It was one of the biggest cross-carpets in football history that, you know, affected so many people. Van Persie switching lanes to Manchester United. It's not a big deal. The guy wants to win trophies.
Yeah.
But people feel betrayed. They feel like someone has robbed them. A lot of people who grew up watching Van Persie mature at the Emirates at Highbury, ladies and gentlemen, feel betrayed right about that. As bad as it bad, if you're going to leave, go to another country.
It's only normal.
Don't stay in the same, you know, league where we are. The guy switches over to Manchester United. It's really bad.
But Alfred, do you know? Actually, I'm an Arsenal fan, all right? I'm an Arsenal, a diehard Arsenal
test
fan.
You right now. All right, okay. Know your loyalty.
Don't start now. But jokes apart, all right? I mean, if you look at this thing again, you want to look at the business side of it, you know what I'm saying?
The business side of it, I agree.
You know, but I mean, in as much as it is, I mean, we had Henri at the point, all right, he had to leave.
Yeah, he went
but
to
then, look at the team he went to.
He went to another country, so it's good and fine.
I mean, it's all football, man. Come on, we want to see good football.
I'm just going to take it out of the realm of football now. Yeah. Let's expand this equation for a bit so the ladies can actually give me their own.
Actually, I have an experience, man.
How do you deal with betrayal?
Believe me.
How do you deal with when you just realize that someone very close to you just betrayed you in the deepest, most vile way ever? The person betrayed you totally. How do you deal with that kind of situation?
Believe me, at first, all right, you first of all, like, kind of lose all your guards. Like, you know, you just don't expect kind of stuff to happen. Like, in my case, all right, believe me, it was back then, like in school, you know, I used to have, I have this girlfriend, like, you know, beautiful girl. Yeah, beautiful, like, you know, yeah, still, yeah, like, yeah, very beautiful girl, yeah. Like, you know, then, you know, like, my friend stays in the other school, like, I'll go, and then just the guy, like, you know, you need to see this girl, beautiful.
Okay, yeah.
And only for me to find out that this guy actually now, like, you know, before you knew what's up, I just went to this guy's house on a very Sunday morning like that. You know, the next night, I saw this girl in my guy's apartment cooking yam and an egg. With a rapper, man.
Yeah, I was like,
Before we go back to another journalism, I got some really, really great guys at Willing. I've been telling you about them all evening long. From Kingsbridge Entertainment, ladies and gentlemen, I got two really, really talented guys. One of them is an actor slash singer. The other one is a plain Afro hip hop singer, like he put it, Bass 10, ladies and gentlemen, and traps it in the building. Give it up for them, ladies and gentlemen. From Kingsbridge, they sent both of you, Tribeson and my main man, Bass 10. So, guys, introduce yourselves to Lagos, man. It's a holiday. Definitely someone wants to hear you say something.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lagos and everyone. This is Tribeson Dudukoko. You all know me as the guy that played the lead role as Dagreen.
He did a fantastic job on that one.
I know this guy.
Now the guy with this, now the humble boy with this. Good to be on the program with us, obviously.
Man, nice to have you, man. Fantastic. Yeah. What about you, Bass?
Yeah, man. Still your boy, Bass 10 Star General. The whole guy you've always known, the guy with the insane video with Terry G. Way back, a few years back. Yeah.
Oh, easy.
I'm back again, and I'm still here. I'm not going nowhere. I'm always here. And right now, we're about to just make your night perfect.
No shoe shine, man.
Not to today's market, man. This 10 Star General, still here on reading.
That's what's up, man. Yeah. We've got some great Recross music coming your way. This one is from his brand new album, from my guys in the building, man. We're going to get to you guys in a bit. The numbers are down 01-95-00-936. True or false questions. If you know them from anywhere, call them out. Owe you money. I just wanted to come on this show. Now is the time to expose them, please. Yeah, are you guys in anybody money? Let's just clarify now.
Don't trust them, man.
I'm a main man, Andre 3000, coming through. Title of this one, 16 bars is never enough.
Holla back.
water.